Welcome to our channel, dear viewers. If you haven't subscribed yet, kindly do so. Today we delve into the royal rift that has captured the world's attention. Imagine a tale of two royal couples bound by blood and duty, yet separated by a chasm of misunderstanding and resentment. In the heart of this narrative are William and Kate, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, and Harry and Meghan, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. This isn't just a tale spun by tabloid writers or gossip mongers. This is a story that comes to us from none other than royal expert Robert Jobson, the man who has spent years studying and observing the British monarchy. In his latest book, Catherine, the Princess of Wales, a biography of the future Queen, Jobson unveils the intricate dynamics of the royal family, focusing specifically on the relationship between our two royal couples. The narrative he presents is as riveting as it is troubling. At the heart of the tale, we find a paradox. Initially, the public's reaction to Meghan was overwhelmingly positive. The new kids on the block were making headlines and capturing hearts. It was a breath of fresh air in the royal narrative. Yet, according to Jobson, this very popularity may have stirred the pot of rivalry. He suggests that William and Catherine may have unconsciously upped their game, driven by the whispers of pettiness and jealousy. This was the point where the relationships began to show cracks. Jobson writes of petty slights, whether imagined or real, that began to widen the rift between the couples. The relationship seemed to be sliding towards a point of no return. So what exactly led to these whispers of pettiness and jealousy? How did the royal relationship start to disintegrate? Is there more to this tale than meets the eye? And most importantly, how do the Sussexes fit into this narrative? As we delve deeper into this royal rift, we hope to uncover the truth behind the headlines. So what exactly led to these whispers of pettiness and jealousy? Let's explore. When Meghan Markle entered the royal scene, public reaction was overwhelmingly positive. She was a breath of fresh air, an American actress with a strong sense of social justice, marrying into the British royal family, a modern fairy tale, if you will. It was a time of excitement and optimism, with the world watching on, eager to see how this new chapter would unfold. Meghan and Prince Harry, as the newlyweds, were the talk of the town. They were fresh, they were exciting, they were the new kids on the block. Their star power was undeniable, and it seemed like they were everywhere. The world couldn't get enough of them. Their marriage, their tours, their charity work, everything they did was under the microscope. And the public loved them for it. They were a breath of fresh air, a spark of modernity in the centuries-old institution that is the British monarchy. This sudden shift in public attention was not unnoticed by the other members of the royal family. Prince William and Catherine, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, had been the golden couple of the monarchy. They were the future king and queen, the face of the monarchy's future. But now they found themselves in the shadows, their spotlight stolen by the new royal couple. It was a time of adjustment for William and Kate. They had to adapt, to change, they had to raise their game. And they did. They increased their public appearances, took on more royal duties, and became more involved in charitable causes. It was a subtle shift, but a shift nonetheless. A shift brought about by the arrival of Meghan and Harry. But as we know, this positive atmosphere did not last. Cracks began to appear. The unity of the royal family started to crumble. The media started picking sides. The public started picking sides. And the fairy tale started to seem more like a Shakespearean tragedy. But that, dear listeners, is a story for another time. As time passed, petty slights, imagined or not, led to a widening rift between the two royal couples. The once harmonious relationship between the Waleses and the Sussexes began to unravel, thread by thread, in a tapestry of tension and rivalry. In the grand halls of Buckingham Palace, whispers of jealousy and resentment echoed through the corridors. These whispers, according to royal expert Robert Jobson, were not without merit. He paints a vivid picture of the escalating tension in his book, Catherine, the Princess of Wales, a biography of the future queen. Imagine a royal garden party where the air is thick with more than just the scent of blooming flowers. The underlying tension is almost tangible. As the couples exchange pleasantries with strained smiles, or picture a state banquet where the clinking of silverware is the only sound that dares to break the silence. These are the scenes that Jobson presents in his detailed account of the Royal Rift. William and Catherine, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, were no longer the sole darlings of the public eye. A new couple, Harry and Meghan, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, had arrived on the scene and they were stealing the spotlight. And, as Jobson suggests, this shift in public adoration may have sparked a sense of competition, a need to raise their game. But it wasn't just a matter of public perception. The cracks in the crown went deeper. There were instances of perceived slights and disrespect that further fueled the simmering resentment. William and Kate felt overshadowed, outshone, and perhaps even threatened by the Sussexes' rapidly rising star. The royal family, an institution steeped in tradition and decorum, was not immune to the all too human feelings of jealousy and insecurity. And it was these emotions that were slowly but surely driving a wedge between the two couples. Soon the relationship seemed irreparable, but how did William and Kate react to this? Reports suggest that William and Kate may have felt a twinge of jealousy at Harry and Meghan's success. Now, let's delve into this sea of green-eyed monsters and try to understand the dynamics of this royal rivalry. It's easy to imagine the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, William and Kate, standing on their royal balcony, looking out at the world that was once solely their stage. Enter Harry and Meghan, the new, vibrant couple that quickly managed to steal the limelight. They brought a fresh perspective, a modern outlook, and an undeniable charisma that captivated audiences worldwide. Suddenly, the world's eyes were on them, leaving William and Kate grappling with a feeling they were perhaps unaccustomed to jealousy. It's important to remember that the royal family is not just a family, it's a brand, a centuries-old institution. Each member plays a part in upholding its image. But when Harry and Meghan began to outshine the future king and queen, it's conceivable that a sense of envy may have crept in. Robert Jobson, in his new book, hints at this possibility. He suggests that William and Kate may have unconsciously upped their game in response to the popularity of the Sussexes. Speculations have added another layer to the complex narrative of the Royal Rift. It's an intriguing saga with twists and turns that keep royal enthusiasts hooked. But let's not forget about Harry and Meghan. How did they handle this situation? Harry and Meghan were not oblivious to the tensions within the family. They were acutely aware of the whispers and the frosty undercurrents. However, they chose not to let it deter them. Instead, they took it in their stride, demonstrating a resilience and determination that is truly commendable. They were determined to carve out their own path, to create a life that was true to their values and aspirations. This fortitude was not without its challenges, of course. There were moments of doubt, moments of frustration. But through it all, they remained steadfast, committed to their vision of a more inclusive and progressive world. They refused to let the shadows of jealousy and resentment darken their path. Instead, they chose to shine brightly, illuminating the way forward with grace and courage. The Royal Rift is a complex issue with many layers and perspectives to consider. Every story has two sides, and the Royal Rift is no exception. As we've journeyed through this tale of two royal couples, we've seen an intriguing play of power dynamics. The rise of the Sussexes, the new kids on the block, as it were, seemed to have sparked a competitive spirit, if not an undertone of jealousy within the Waleses. The cracks in the crown widened with pettiness and imagined slights adding fuel to the fire. While it's easy to point fingers, it's important to remember that these are real people with real emotions at play. We've also seen the Sussexes' stance, their resilience in the face of adversity, and their determination to carve out their own path. It's a fascinating narrative, one that encourages us all to reflect on the nature of power, fame, and family. Thank you for joining us today. Remember to subscribe, like, and share our content. Stay tuned for more insightful discussions on our channel.